Hello, I'm Mr. R. Mitchell, a retired lecturer in rheumatology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. The second coming of Jesus was in 1469 in the name of Nanak. And he preached gospel for 150 years through six light. So let's do this. Luke 1 verse 26 onward. Birth of Jesus foretold. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee. This God is Yahweh, you know, because Yahweh is the God of nature. So, and he is the one who produces this flesh, to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. He has to appear among the house of David, in the line of David, and no one else, because in the previous age, people of Judah tribe, of which David is, belongs to, they were so good, you know, they were with angels, angelic people, perfect in the moral laws. And in this dark age, they become opposite. They become number one crook. So doctor is needed by the spiritually sick people of Judah tribe. That's why Jesus spent most of his lifetime in the Judea region to cure them. But they kicked him in the face and killed him. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favoured one. The Lord Yahweh is with you." Angels work for Lord Yahweh. They are the messengers. And inside the person is the Christ. That you receive it from our Father God. So this body is all concerned with Yahweh. But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God Yahweh. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus." You know, the word Jesus stands in Hebrew is called Yeshua. Yeh is from Yahweh, Shua is Adam. So he was the firstborn of Yahweh as the Father, you know, Heavenly Father. And he was second Adam, because this earth belongs to one Adam only, not to two. So that's why Jesus came as a floating Adam, leaving no mark on this earth. All these stories they are making that Jesus married with Mary Magdalene, had children and all that, is to make fool of the people. And there are many fools who will believe in that such story, you know, because they are men of letters. Men of letters cannot understand the things of spirit unless they think from the third eye of logical reasoning. These two eyes can only see. Like the Samaritan woman, they said, had five husbands. So this two eye will say, "Oh, there are five husbands." But when you think with the third eye of logical reasoning, then you will find they were spiritual, they were not physical. So spiritual things are beyond the capability of the once-born men of letters. They end up as super donkeys carrying holy books. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, you have found favor with God, Yahweh. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, the Christ, Most High Elohim. And the Lord Yahweh, and the Lord God Yahweh will give to him the throne of his father David." Now it's a corruption, you know, these messianic Jews, they always have been trying to think that they will have secular kingdom, greed, secular kingdom. Jesus was to be born in the family of David, in the line of David, as the second coming of Jesus, Satguru equal to Christ, Nanak was born in the family of Shri Ram Chander ji, who was a Khatri, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Now here is the evil nature of the chosen people. You know the 11 crook? Jacob had 12 sons. 11 were crook. And Joseph was only one who was faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. So they sold him to, they wanted to kill him first. But then they sold him to Egyptian as a slave. And he became a great man among the Egyptians, for his wisdom was great. And these crook brothers then went to beg food from him, and all that story, you know it. So they are crook, you know, and they are still displaying this nature. This generation of the Joseph are Samaritans. You remember woman at the well? She said, "This is the well which Jacob gave them." So that was the Jacob's favorite son was Joseph, for he was the salt of Abraham and Isaac. Now, chosen people, especially of the Judah tribe, is displayed. Jesus was the royal king, not the king, royal king, and the royal kingdom has no boundaries as gospel is preached all over the world. So gospel is for everyone, you know, not for one country. So Christ come for everyone, whole world. And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God, Yahweh," you know, he is Jesus. Remember, Jesus' heavenly father is Yahweh. That's why Jesus said, "Every plant which my heavenly father did not plant shall be uprooted." So he will be the son of Yahweh. Flesh, you know. God is spirit, and what is born of flesh are of Yahweh, Brahma or Khudah, we call them, etc., is flesh of nature, you know, they are. And what is born of spirit is spirit, which you cannot see. Nature you can see, spirit you cannot see. So that is the Christ quality. And behold, your relative, Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren by the people, reproaches, you know, the people. For nothing will be impossible with God, our spiritual father, who overrules nature, as Jesus demonstrated through the miracles, you know, walking over the water, and all that miracle shows that he is the dominant over nature. And so we are, you know, in God. Least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist, an ideal rabbi. And Mary said, "Behold, I am the servant of Lord Yahweh. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. So this is a one part. So we do it short. They will be interesting. So there you are, the angel came and told her. So Mary became the surrogate mother of Jesus. And the father of Christ, which is spirit, is our father God, which is spirit. So what is born of flesh of Yahweh is flesh. What is born of spirit, our God Father, is spirit. Our Father God blesses you.